Welcome to the Rebel Love Show. Sorry about the technical issues, but we are now live on LRN.fm. I am Ram Mathias.
And I am the Rebel Mistress. And now our mics are muted, so...
Hey, all right. But it's a learning hospital, and this is the first maiden voyage out of our new studio here.
This is the Rebel Love Studios 1.5.
Why, then why are you calling it 1.5?
It's 1.5.
You know, you're only saying 1.5 because you don't want this to be like the 2.0 studio forever.
Well, no, I think that it's gonna keep evolving. So we can't just give it a 2.0. We can't just be easy.
I don't know if I even believe in numbers anymore.
Forget numbers. But this studio,
who cares what version of it is? It's still the studio. It's the here and now. That's what the studio is.
This studio is great because it's just so end capped. Like the walls are yellow, and I think it was just such a great touch. It's really what makes the Rebel Love Studios like just badass. I really like the foam in here compared to the walls. It's great. You did a good job painting. He's a manly man.
I try to be, but to be perfectly honest, I'm not. But this studio was pink. I don't know if you've been following me on Facebook. Like, it was a pink room when we moved here. I'm like, no, I'm not doing a pink room. That ain't going to happen. So, yeah, we changed it up. This is almost my dream studio of what I would want to be.
Almost? What else do you need?
Oh, we need a bunch of new stuff. Like, I definitely want newer cameras, for one. That's one thing I'd definitely like to see is newer cameras. Well, we only have one really good one.
Well, now we have two green screens. And Rob was saying on our failed intro that the colors really coincide really well with each other, except for the green screens. And now we have a DMT trip just constantly in the background.
Oh, but we're going to change it up. So if you're listening to LRN.fm and you want to check out what we're talking about, just go to rebelloveshow.com, click on live. So this is our main voyage. So like right now I can put like whatever I want behind us, which is I have a bunch of different stuff queued up. But
we got some funny stuff for you. So you might want to go check us out. Go give us a click. So Rob is going to announce some exciting updates because he's been picked up multiple times. I don't know if it's been in the course of a month because we're in Shire years. I don't know how long it's been. He got pulled over. How long ago was that?
That was like 2 weeks ago. Not even 2 weeks ago.
Not even?
Yeah, I got...
And well, yeah. That video has, you can find it on YouTube.
It's picked up by different, like anti-cop.
Yeah,
and there were police accountability websites.
Yes, and there were two articles written about it. It's hilarious. I think people are just. I love the headings of it. It's just like, oh, this cop threatens to gladly arrest a citizen for a light bulb. Like how gladly, like it's just great. Well,
I mean, during that whole video, I had a confrontation with him where I'm like, look, are you going to arrest me knowing that this warrant be issued over a light bulb? And this guy says, yeah, he would. You would definitely do that.
No problem. I'll come put the cuffs on you myself.
Yeah. You'd gladly do it.
So, I mean, I think you guys should go check out that video if you haven't looked at it and you want to see what we're talking about. And, you know, put some nice comments down. So, what is our big update?
Well, the big news, like, first off, this is the best activism I've seen in a long time. Basically, LRN is now being played on an affiliate out in California, in San Francisco, on KGAY 88.1 FM.
Wait, it's called K-Gay?
Yes, it's K-Gay. So if you're listening to us driving around San Francisco right now, go check us out, rebelloveshow.com, and check out LRN.fm with all the great content coming out there. But what I find...
Isn't it a bit suspicious? Derek J moves to San Francisco, and all of a sudden... There's a pirate, LRN.fm. I'm not accusing him of anything.
Well, what makes it pirate? Because they didn't get someone who's launching that radio station didn't get permission.
What's so wrong with pirates? I like pirates.
Oh, me too.
Okay. Yeah. but I mean, when does that air again?
We're on the air right now in San Francisco. This is live, yeah.
Well, hello, San Francisco. Check out our good friend Derek J. He's doing some great stuff. And what is that talk? Free San Francisco. I don't remember. I should have looked it up. They do a show out of there.
Oh, with his boyfriend?
Yeah, with his boyfriend, which is a good show.
Free Talk San Francisco.
Free Talk San Francisco. So that's great. And is it in Europe?
No. What I wanted to make a point about is the fact that whenever Liberty activists are throwing up pirate stations of LRN, I kind of find that to be like Radio Free Europe in the U.S. back during the Cold War. We're basically using radio to get the, you know, speak about freedom and stuff like that into, you know, behind the Iron Curtain. And I kind of feel like we're behind the Iron Curtain now, but instead of it, someone else throwing
we're the resistance.
We're like the French Resistance, like launching LRN, signals everywhere.
That's cool. I never thought about it this way. So every time we do the show, it's just activism. We're giving those people in Africa liberty.
There's people in Ghana listening to us right now.
I bet they hate you.
Why would they hate me? They love me in Ghana. What's not the love?
Yeah, that's very true. Well, speaking of freedom and pirate radios and everything, I feel like every time I leave work, there's people outside holding these fucking signs. Vote for this person. Vote for this person. And I just want to vomit a little bit.
There's one of the best ones I've seen lately. It's like vote for a problem solver or something like that. These yard signs popping up. I don't know if it's a joke or it's actually for an actual candidate.
That's the thing. I always think this political campaigning is a joke. So, for instance, what is it? Trump, make America good again. I'm like, is that a joke?
Yeah, I think it is.
Is that a joke?
It's so full of itself where you want to think it actually is.
I mean, I think it might be. He is a joke. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. I know Rob votes, and I judge him for that, honestly.
That I vote?
Yeah.
Well, I don't vote for national elections.
But you vote. You vote. But when we come back, we'll talk about why voting is a four-letter word. It's a bad word, people. Bad word.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show.
Are you going to tell everyone how to pirate a radio station?
Yeah.
Just in case you wanted to know.
In case you're curious on how a pirate radio starts or forms or anything along those lines, it's pretty much done for you because LRN.FM is there. If you go to LRN.FM/broadcast and you're looking to start up your own pirate radio, but you don't have any programming, LRN comes in. Go check that out. I would love to see all these pop up around the country, actually around the world. I'd love to see little pirate radio stations everywhere. Maybe one day it will be in Manch again, but to my knowledge, there is not an LRN.FM running in Manch, unfortunately.
Oh, maybe you should be the one, babe. You got too much shit to do already.
Yeah, I do too much shit. Someone who has the technical know-how should do that. I don't really.
I'll pirate a radio station.
You'll pirate. Is it really pirate if you're getting the content for free? Like, is that really a pirate? Because, like, you know, Ian wants, you know, LRN to be pirated and put everywhere. So is that really pirating?
It's
pirating. It is pirating in regards to like going against the law about, you know, starting your own radio station without permission, civil disobedience.
Yeah, because they want to monitor what you're saying, which is why they don't want us to say this. Why vote is a four-letter word. I do not believe in voting. I myself have never voted.
Ever.
Ever.
Ever, ever, ever.
Ever.
Not even like, you know, grade school or like or high school for like school class elections.
Okay, I have never voted in anything on the state or federal level.
What about local levels? What about the city council or something?
Never.
Like school board?
Never.
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 Well, why don't you vote, babe?
I don't vote because why would I take part in people trying to say that they are authority in me by... It's just dignified. If I'm going to go expend my energy, right? Oh, yeah, this person can tell me what to do. Oh, I like what this person is saying. I can be his slave a little bit better than I can be this person. Like, I don't believe in it. Like, I never have. And, well, okay, there was once I thought that I did, and it was back when. who was it? It was the Obama phase. Everyone was like, Obama, 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 change, change, change. But, I mean, it was 2009, and I still wasn't old enough to vote, so it didn't matter. And then when the next term came around, and I was old enough to vote, and they were, like, watching debates in my college, like, just, like, every night they'd go and watch the fucking debates. And everyone went to go vote, and they, like, gave me this form so I could, like, become, so I could vote in New Hampshire. I mean, sorry, in Massachusetts.
Well, that wouldn't be out of the ordinary. A lot of times, mass holes bring up other mass holes to vote in New Hampshire politics. It's really easy to do voter fraud because you just have to say you live at a certain location. Like, you can vote, like, just walking in.
Yeah. Well, I could send in a vote, and I just didn't.
Which I'm not really against voter fraud, but that's a whole other.
I just didn't. I look at things on a much bigger picture, and on that much bigger picture, I believe no one has authority over me. So why would I vote for someone? That doesn't make sense, because how would I vote for someone who has no power in my eyes?
But that's the system we live in. That's what that we're in that system. Don't you want to try to change the system from within, or at least slow it down, throw like a wrench into the gears just to stop it a little bit?
Okay, but who voting for who would do that?
Oh, with Rand Paul, of course. Rand Paul.
Oh my God, the lesser of evil is still evil. And I even when my local friends run, I'm not going to vote. I'm sorry.
Well,
I take an MVG stance on it. Like, they say, oh, MVG. I'm going to go and, you know, infiltrate the system and work from the inside. He said for him, it's like, oh, I'm going to go infiltrate the Klan. You know, just try to work from the inside to make things better. It's the same concept. It's an evil, corrupt system. And I don't feel like that's the way to break it. I feel like we break it by being disobedient, by not voting, by showing that they have no authority. Because once the masses, you know, once they all say, hey, you know, this is wrong. Why am I voting? Fuck those guys. If we all stop listening, they wouldn't have no power.
MVG is notorious for going after porks for supporting the system and voting. Like, he's, like, pretty much gone after everyone for doing that at this point.
And I support him. Like, he really helped me. I mean, I love watching him speak at these conferences. Is he going to Keenvention?
Oh, he better be going to Keenvention.
He should have done a speech because he was really great and inspirational to look at. I mean, listen to. And he says things that make you think, like, oh, I've never thought of it that way before. It's just like Derek J's victimless crime spree. It's like, you've never thought of it that way before until he kind of puts it in front of you. And you're like, oh, you know what he's saying. It's true. It's the truth. So I think going out and voting or running for office or whatever, it may throw a wrench in there. And good for you. If you know you go in there with good intents, it's just not for me. I'm just not personally going to support you.
No, I hear you on that. I mean, like for me, like I want to see porks win like office, because honestly, the reason why I want that to happen is because I understand that from a minarchist point of view, once you get around a bunch of, you know, volunteers and anarchists, you kind of give them 6 months to a year and they convert. So I'm all in favor of there being a more minarchist in the fold coming through and coming in here. That's why I'm not totally against the idea of porcupines taking part in local elections.
I mean, people can do whatever the fuck they want to do at the end of the day. I'm just saying, I'm not
voting. No, I hear you. I'm probably not going to vote either. Like, I have before in local elections. You know, most of them were just writing stuff anyways. But it took everything I had just to do it, and I kind of regretted doing it. The only reason why I did it is because there's three different porcupines on the ballot, so I wanted to support them.
Yeah, I mean, if we get them all in there and, you know, all the way to the presidency, then...
You think a porcupine is going to run for
yeah.
Run for president?
Well, actually, that's all we need. Just him to get to the president, and then all of them in the state and the Senate. I don't know. But at the end of the day, I don't believe in voting. I think voting is evil. It's not love.
Well, why do you think voting is evil? Like, I understand it's wrong, and you're voting for someone. Your vote is almost an endorsement of the system which you live in, which you don't agree
with.
I get that.
You're endorsing evil.
You're endorsing evil.
Yeah. You're endorsing you're endorsing a system that you don't believe in.
Well, you know, Bernie Sanders thinks that voting should be everyone should be automatically registered to vote. Like, he wants a complete overhaul of voting.
Okay,
voting
can I
system.
Ask you something before we get into politics?
Yeah.
So the people at your jobs and stuff, do they ever talk to you about politics? Do they ever make you see something that you didn't see?
Has a coworker in any job or situation? Yes. Yeah, I have changed my way of thought based off of conversations I've had with coworkers in the past. Yes.
For instance.
My red pill moment was actually because of a coworker.
What do you say?
Well, basically, this goes back to way like 2006, way before YouTube. I used to be small government conservative, rah-rah USA. He gave me the red pill moment, and I'll come back with that after the break. A trip to the market.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, Rob was giving us his red pill moment. The moment a coworker changed his life by asking about politics.
Yeah. So, see, this is where I go into, like, first off, I don't talk about it usually on air because I have no way of proving it. But long story short, I was told to go watch this documentary about 9/11. I came down this hole from, 9/11 Truth Movement. So,
what was the video?
Oh, and Loose Change. The video was Loose Change. It was a popular documentary about a decade ago.
About what? I don't know it.
About how 9/11, wasn't exactly an inside job, but just questioned the official story on 9/11.
Okay, what did they think the official story was?
Oh, on Loose Change?
Yeah.
on Loose Change, basically, they throw out how the towers had to be demolished. The jet fuel didn't bring it down.
Oh, they had to be blown up.
Yeah,
not a plane.
That a third plane did not hit Building 7. No plane actually hit Building 7.
So, what did the coworker ask you to make you go?
No, he kept talking about it and bringing up points, and I was always going against him. And he's like, "Just watch this and try and prove me wrong." And I started trying to prove him wrong and do my own research. But then I kind of went. That led me down to other documentaries.
Yeah.
Okay, and then from there, I discovered Ron Paul, and I discovered the Liberty scene, and just kept going farther, farther, farther down.
Oh. That's cool.
Yeah, so that was that pinpoint moment where I can go back.
Went farther down than him.
Oh, yeah, I passed him up. Yeah, he's still a status. He's way back there. Yeah.
Wow. How can someone even be a status after? First of all, never believe anything that your government is telling you. They're not telling you the whole story. Even if they're telling you a portion of it, it's not the whole story. It's not the true story. So I never believe anything.
Anything they do say is usually just to distract you from something else that's going on.
It's propaganda. It's all just propaganda. And we're just buying into it.
Well, they're just doing whatever they can to keep their power.
That's very true.
At the end of the day, people who want power, they just want more power.
Yeah, they won't give it up easily. Never have. They never will.
So what about you? Do they bring up politics at your job? Have you ever had that?
First of all, I work in a office.
Yeah, don't talk about your job on where you work on air.
Yeah, I work in an office, and there's a lot of political stuff going on in that building.
An epicenter.
The first floor is a bunch of libertarians, I guess. Or I don't even know if they are libertarians. I don't know.
They would argue yes, they are. I would argue probably not.
They say they're the Rand Paul of libertarians.
No, they're probably no. It depends. Sometimes they're good on things. Sometimes they're not.
Well, yeah,
we're talking about AFP, but for those people that don't know what we're talking about,
there's the megacorp on the next floor above them, and the total opposite of everything that they're talking about. And then just on the side of the street, I got hitting your mic. I just got people just rallying for Hillary, and it's really weird. It's just a really weird triangle going on here. So people do talk about it, and I work for a nonprofit. So I don't know. Like, I was telling Roth, the general consensus is everyone hates cops. Like, everyone hates cops.
Usually
I
can say, that's the case.
Yeah, you can say, fuck the cops. Ain't nobody going to be like, hey. And most people are like, yeah, I mean, I guess you're right. But I guess at my work, it's just since it is, like, public service, I guess. No, my job really isn't. It's private and publicly funded.
You're like a, it's like a private company that kind of works for government agencies sometimes.
Sometimes, but they make them pay. So, I mean, I guess it's on other people's tax dollars, but that's the government's fault.
That's true.
But I don't know. I mean, it's a nice job. But anyway, they talk about public service a lot. So, for instance, they'll talk about governmental assistance. And, I mean, Rob was just looking at an article today about the Facebook guy giving like $100 million,
like $992 million to Planned Parenthood. I believe I saw that somewhere online.
Not government philanthropy. So I mean, I feel like that definitely makes a statement on like when people start talking about public service. What would people do if other people didn't take care of them? First of all, I just think we shouldn't have to be forced to. But I don't ever say that at work when they talk about it. I just don't say anything, kind of, if they talk about public service. But if they start talking about, like, Bush and Donald Trump and everything, I'm just like, did you just talk about Bush? And they all know I'm a hippie. So they're like, oh, well, what do you think? And I'm like, well, I just think that we should have open borders. I mean, we're all humans. We should all have the right to travel across this country. I said this to my boss, actually, and he was like, you would think that.
Isn't your boss an immigrant to begin with?
No, not that one. Oh, okay. The other guy.
I gotcha.
Yeah, but yeah, I'm like, I believe in open borders. Like, and then if they talk about Trump or something, which is really funny, like everyone thinks he's an idiot. Like, it's general like consistent. I'm like, oh, like, vote for Trump. You know, he's the president America deserves.
If you go to his website, he has two positions, like, on issues, like literally just two. That's it. One of them being the Second Amendment, and the other one is, I'm going to build a wall against Mexico. Like, he literally wants to build a Berlin Wall against Mexico, and he's for gun rights. Cool, I'm down for gun rights, but, like, that's literally, like, his two issues on the internet, on his website.
Well, I love how you have Trump in the background. I guess we're going to go straight into Trump. So, the thing about him is, when people talk about him at work, it's always... It's just a very funny situation because he would like you to think that he is worth a lot more than he actually is. And if you could really see his circumstances, I'll just say he's filed for bankruptcy 4 years in a row. I think.
But he bounces back up. He knows how to bring it up. He just doesn't know how to hold on to it.
He knows how to bring it up, or is he just bluffing?
Maybe he is. He's a good bluffer.
Yeah,
I'll give him that.
I think he's ballsy. He's literally bluffing. And you made the comment that Donald Trump is like vermin supreme.
No, he's like a legit vermin supreme. Because, like, the only difference I can
really... Can we get vermin supreme on the camera here?
Yeah. The only difference I can see between vermin supreme and Donald Trump is that the mainstream media somehow gives Donald Trump, like, credibility, and they don't give vermin supreme credibility. That and vermin supreme is for ponies, for everyone. And I don't really think Donald Trump supports ponies.
He does support legalization of all drugs, but it would be monopolized by the state, and they get taxes from it.
Wouldn't it be like a 100% tax then?
Yeah,
100% controlled by state, and state controlled everything anyways.
Yeah, so he votes for legalization for that purpose, which. People are like, oh, well, it's legalization.
Well, one thing that's also cool with Trump that's weird, it's not cool, but, like, I find hilarious is, like, he's basically a creditable vermin supreme. He's such a caricature of, like, how people make fun of politics. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a reason why people make fun of politics, and he's, like, that caricature of it, but he's legit. Like, he's actually, like, he could win the presidency.
He's
leading the polls. He's leading the polls in a Republican primary.
I don't see how he's legit at all. Like, first of all, he's just, like, the sexist, racist,
yeah,
like...
Yeah, he's legit. He's not hiding behind, like, some sort of, you know,
Vermin Supreme would be a dictator, but every everyone responsible. Like, that's it. That's his only stance. I'm a dictator. You get free ponies. Everyone brushes Donald their Trump teeth. No, Donald Trump is, give me all your money. I'm going to tax the shit out of you.
And he's going to make Mexico pay for a fucking wall.
Yes. He's going to build a fucking Berlin Wall for Mexicans and make them pay for it. And this is the question no one gets. I keep asking. How is he going to back that wall? Blood. That's the only way he's building a fucking wall, like, to fucking keep Mexicans out, is blood. He's going to back that with the gun. And no one's thinking about that.
That's what taxation is.
Well, yeah.
It's just violence backed by a gun and theft.
Well, more about what Donald Trump needs to do to win this election. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, where we are being very politico tonight. So you might have asked, just in case you were wondering, probably not if you're listening to this radio station, but who is running for president? I got a list from the New York Times. It's more than a dozen Republicans and just a handful of Democrats have announced they're running for their party's 2016 presidential nomination.
You know, this is good information for me, because I'll be honest, I have not really paid attention to national politics since I moved.
So yeah, this is kind of like whatever.
This is kind of like an anarchist perspective for me of like who's actually running, because like I stopped really caring, but I'm still, which I did a long time ago.
You gotta know who's.
I should still know who's saying that they want to rule over me. So yeah, I kind of do need to know that.
Okay, so Lincoln Chafee, who's a former Rhode Island governor, is pretty much the first person who comes up. Do you know who Lincoln Chafee is?
No, he's from Rhode Island. No one gives a shit about people from Rhode Island.
That's true. He enjoys challenges, and today we have many facing Americans. That is his slogan. We got the Americans have the problems? Many of them. He says his stance is Iraq is key. As a Republican senator, Mr. Chafee cast the party's lone vote against the Iraq war. Would you vote for him?
No, I still wouldn't vote for him.
Whoever you are, Lincoln Chafee.
Not voting for the Iraq war.
Whoever you are, from Rhode Island guy, maybe he's like, isn't Family Guy from Rhode Island?
That's the only connection you have with him, yes.
That's it. The next one is great. Hillary Rodham Clinton.
Now, we were talking about this earlier, and I want to bring it up with Hillary. You know, I honestly believe that Hillary would be president by now had she gotten a divorce from Bill Clinton. Because, you know, and honestly, I don't feel sorry for her. And I kind of think I would have come. This is coming from, you know, me being Polly. Like, she should have divorced the shit out of Clinton. We probably would have had Hillary Rodham as president.
Yeah, I would vote for Hillary Rodham.
You would vote for Hillary Rodham just because you're like, you know what? She got a divorce, you know, in the public limelight. Like, why not?
No, because it just amazes me that people are like, oh, she stayed with him. Like, how strong? I'm like, first of all, she couldn't handle the presidential dick. Like, he's getting a blowjob under the table at his speeches, and you're, like, standing on the sidelines. And, you know, he comes out publicly, I'm sorry, America. And you just stand beside him like nothing ever happened. You're still with him today. He's probably still getting a blowjob, from, like, under his desk from the same person. And I can't take her seriously, is the thing.
Maybe they have an open marriage. They just don't talk about it openly.
Maybe they do have an open marriage, or maybe. I don't know. If they came out and said they had an open marriage, I'd vote
too.
For her. But, you know, none of that has happened. And so it just looks like she's just like this. She's him. She's his presidential beard.
What do you mean by presidential beard?
He's running again and through her vagina, basically. So he's running for president through her vagina.
See, her vagina, she still should have got the divorce and got remarried as soon as she got into president. Who back to Bill.
No, I don't know. Hillary, people are like, oh, woman for president. But really, that woman? I just...
Well, she's a war criminal. I mean, she's done so much stuff in regards to, like, especially as Secretary of State, the whole Benghazi stuff.
Yeah, former Secretary of State. Everyday Americans need a champion, and I want to be that champion. Okay, first of all, I have so many problems with this statement. Did Hillary Clinton just volunteer as tribute for the Hunger Games? Because what does she mean?
I don't know. I mean,
they're
so collective. Like, if you listen to, like, anything all the presidential candidates are running on, like, almost all of them talk about, like, what we gotta do. They keep saying the word we and us and America and Americans. And, you know, they're so collectivized in their verbiage. Like, there's not really any difference between what they're really saying, regardless of it's a Republican or a Democrat.
Yeah. She just, I want to be your champion. And I just don't, like, really support Hillary. And the best thing happened ever. We were doing a foundation for New Hampshire independence because Rob here is on the board. And we went to...
I need more stuff for that, though. What? I'm a slacktivist.
You are a slacktivist, but that's fine. What were we doing? We were passing out flyers at a fucking military rally or something.
It felt like a military rally.
Where were we?
No, that was on July 3rd. It was the Independence Day celebration that Manchester has.
So we went around passing out flyers, but we all met in the parking lot or whatever to get together, talked about the handing out of flyers, and just a bunch of fucking, like, not hipsters, preppy hipsters. Guys with pink shirts and
they're ready for Hillary, babe.
Yeah, they're ready.
They're
for
ready.
I don't know. Just like your typical fucking douchebaggery, like student cargo shorts. I don't know. Comes up to us in there with their clipboard. Hello, you guys, Hillary supporters. You here for Hillary?
It was hilarious because we're all standing there.
We freeze and just look at him and just burst into laughter. All of us in a group collectively in this guy's face.
This guy has no idea who he was talking to, what group of people he was talking to at all.
And we're just like, absolutely not. And later we handed him a New Hampshire.
Well, you know, during that time, I remember approaching those the Hillary people there. And I actually came up, they didn't go up to them to talk about secession or anything like that. What I actually went up and talked to them about is marijuana legalization. And I'm like, look. The governor of this state, who's right over there, I believe endorsed Hillary or something along those lines, she thinks it's quite okay to kidnap people over a plant and throw them in a cage. Like, you know, as a Hillary Clinton supporter, do you support, you know, innocent people, you know, of victimless crime, of selling a plant to another human being should be kidnapped and thrown in jail by that woman? And they, like, completely, like, you know, obviously try to, you know, not talk about it. It's like, oh, well, you know, every state's different, and I don't know where I stand on legalization.
What? Who doesn't
this
stand
like a 20-year-old,
for,
you know, this is like a 21-year-old college student, and you know he smokes in the dorm.
Oh,
like, you know, like,
God.
Come on.
Like, who doesn't? Like, even like, if you don't smoke marijuana, yeah, I know. I guarantee, like, 20% of your friends do. So I don't, anyone who's like, oh, I don't know about marijuana legalization, that just shows, like, what kind of people are voting for Hillary. These uptight fucking stick in the mud, like, oh, yeah, gay conservatives. I don't know. Like, it's really weird because you would think that it'd be more about equality and freedom, not like, oh, she's a woman.
She wears all the nice pantsuits.
Oh, all her pantsuits?
Yeah, she's got nice pantsuits.
That's to cover her sniz and her snooch.
Yeah, I know.
I've
seen that.
Snooch
yeah.
in her sniz. But I don't know. I don't really care for Hillary. But one of the reasons New York Times thinks that she might win is because of her name recognition.
Well, that's why Jeb's in the running. I don't know how, like, Bush has some sort of, like, name recognition stuff.
But just, like, when you associate Bush, just, like, it should be, like, a shockwave monitor. Just, like, just test it on everyone to see when you think of the name Bush, what do you think of?
Now, I will say this, because I grew up in the 90s. As much as, I'm not a Democrat or a Republican, I'm, you know, obviously an anarchist and whatnot, you know, I kind of liked Clinton when he was a president. Like, I grew up with him as president.
I mean,
he was a cool guy on TV, playing the sax and getting his dick sucked while he's, like, bombing other countries.
I, I definitely approve of Clinton.
Not that it's likable he's doing that.
Getting a blowjob, like, in office. Like, I definitely was like, yes, go Clinton. Like, yes, you know, I'm down for that. But I don't know. I guess, I don't know. I wasn't around for Clinton. I know he had an affair, and I thought that was pretty cool as a kid.
You thought it was cool that he had an affair?
Yeah. I was like, oh, you know, it shows his humanity.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, everyone likes to get blowjobs. Why not me? Just because I have a wife. I don't think him and Hillary. Do you think him and Hillary sleep together?
I bet they still do. I bet they do.
I bet they sleep in separate rooms.
No, no.
Or they sleep in the same room with two beds.
They're probably kinksters. They're probably like into like huge orgies or something like that.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You just think everyone's into huge orgies is what it is.
Not everyone's into huge orgies, but if there's an orgy that's happening.
But the Clintons?
Oh, the Clintons for sure. I mean, you can probably go into whole Illuminati shit with Clintons as it is. If you want to go down that road, which I really don't want to.
So, yeah, because you're crazy. We can talk about that for another show.
Well, I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I find conspiracy theories fun. I find them fun and entertaining because they're so fantastical. But it doesn't mean I believe them. I just find them entertaining.
You know,
to
we should have a conspiracy theory show with Cody because he has been on the conspiracy
theory. We can get
cast.
Him. Well, maybe he'll be the first Skype-in guest because he won't drive down here. And we can have his head just like hovering over one of ours on the green screen.
That'd be great. More when we come back about who's running. There's a lot more.
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we're coming back to how we're giving you the anarchist perspective on people wanting to rule over your lives this election season.
These people, I don't know. I mean, if I had to choose someone to rule over me, none of these people would be my ideal candidate, you know? Like, if I really had to choose someone to rule over me, I don't know. I think I just can't picture a ruler. Can you picture a ruler for yourself?
No, I cannot picture anyone ruling over me. Well, the only one, I'll take it back. Yes, I can, because I believe I rule myself. So I am over myself.
But then that's just you, so.
Well, that's a ruler.
Yeah, yeah. So I rule myself.
That's where I get kind of into it with like people calling themselves. You know, I call myself an anarchist to make it simple. Well, I don't really believe in that because that's no rulers. I do believe in rulers. I believe everyone's a ruler of each other.
Okay, so would you say that like people who believe in like God and stuff, they believe in having a ruler over them?
Well,
because I can't even picture a God.
Well, I don't believe in someone being a ruler. Like, I believe you can rule over yourself and not having someone else. If you consent to it, sure. Like, I know that a lot of people go on against like, well, that's saying that you're okay with slavery. Like, well, if it's consentive, sure.
Wait, consensual slavery?
Yeah, if you want to be ruled
be
over,
slavery.
If you want, when is
like
exactly?
If it's consensual.
Well, you can make the argument like, well, libertarians and anarchists will make the argument that the system that we live in is a form of slavery.
It is slavery, but it's not
time,
consensual.
People are oblivious. If you vote, if you vote, you're consenting to the system you live in. On top of that, you're also most people are very pro-American.
But most people are also oblivious.
There are a lot of people that are oblivious as well, but there's people that are Florida State, and they understand that. Sometimes you actually run into people that will be fully honest and think, yes, people need to be controlled.
Yes, but if you think about it, they've been going through so many years of indoctrination. Like, they've been in public schools and they're force-fed propaganda their entire lives, and then taught, you know, this is what you grow up to do, this is what you grow up to think, and this is what you should be, and if you're not that way, you're wrong and you're an outcast to society. Because even if you think about this whole thing, like, you don't like really talk about it as publicly as I feel like everyone should, because you feel like, you know, you'd be outcast from society. That's something that's taught, You know, it's something that people are taught generally to be afraid of. Anarchy. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. As soon as you say the word anarchy, people think, like, it's chaos in the streets. There's going to be murder everywhere and, you know, theft and robbery. And
where do you think they're learning that? You know, that's something that they're being force-fed daily. And it takes a lot to step out of the matrix. But I think Ron Paul said it, you know, once someone describes freedom to you, like in philosophy, who wouldn't want to be free? Like, it sounds like it doesn't sound like an awesome thing. It is, you know, to be truly free.
You can't unsee the things that you see finally.
Basically.
When you wake up and you see like the world we live in, that you aren't free, like you can't unsee that you're not free anymore.
Yeah.
Like, you know, some people can
take
that blue
pill. You can't go back to yellow, like, oh, yes, Bush, I'm voting for him next week.
Well, unfortunately, sometimes there are. Sometimes people, like, they acknowledge it, but they're going to do whatever they can from within, like, the system. So, like, they'll still vote for the lesser two evils. They'll still support that system.
Yeah, but then
Though they don't agree with it.
They just keep going back into the same... to the same end. It doesn't get better. Vote harder is not gonna work. But speaking of voting harder, let's see who else is running for president. Lawrence Lessig, do you know him? He's a Harvard professor. His slogan is, "This salesman partisan platform of American politics in Washington right now doesn't work."
No shit.
Wow.
Yeah, of course it doesn't work. Well, actually, I
Thanks
take it
a
back.
Lot,
I will
Lawrence
say
Lessig.
I will say that politics in Washington does work. And if it didn't work, the system wouldn't be in place that we have now today. So that is politics working.
He wants to lessen the money in politics.
What does that even mean?
So
lessen the money.
He wants people to not pay for politicians. Basically, the don't bribe politician stamp. At your local.
See, I never get that. So I'm putting my minute cap on here for a second to talk about that. Basically, people who want to get private funds out of elections, all right, but at the same time, they want campaign to be financed some way, so they want the state to do it. So basically, instead of people voluntarily giving money that, you know, of the company that they run, they think it's better to go after people and steal from people via taxation and then give it to other candidates that you probably don't agree with.
Exactly, but they don't want to put it to you that way. They just want to say
like a better thing.
They don't want to.
It makes it more fair, but it's still just as horrible.
Exactly, they don't want to put it that way. They want to put it like, "Oh, we're stopping all the big businesses from bribing politics," but no. It's the same thing. It's not anything different.
And honestly, like a campaign,
a
campaign donation is like a public thing. Like, and honestly, like these mega corporations and stuff like that. There's different ways to bribe a politician. Like it doesn't have to be via like a campaign donation. And honestly, the politicians are probably bought off. The campaign donation is probably the very last thing that they're
I totally agree. So it's just like that really means nothing, you know. And I think when he says things like that, he's like, "Oh, people who really work hard, but please, there's the 1% for a reason."
First off, one little thing I want to touch on, like arguing over like getting people to vote and stuff like that. All right, like campaigning on how like that's an issue and like. And on top of how, like, candidates run for office and campaign finance reform and vote reform and all that jazz, that's, like, arguing over, like, you know, hey, this chair in the kitchen needs to be fixed when, the toilet in the bathroom is just running and there's water flying everywhere. Like, it's like, okay, yeah, I get that this little thing in this system needs to be fixed, but there's a lot more issues going at play that really need more attention than, you know, campaign finance.
Well, that is Lawrence Lessig's platform, and I totally agree. It's a broken system. Trying to fix one thing is like trying to tape. I don't know. It's horrible. The next person is Martin O'Malley, who was a former Maryland governor. Anything about him?
No.
He wants to save our country. What?
Why? Wait. Why does he want to save this?
Okay, we must save our country now. And we will do that by rebuilding the dream.
Rebuilding the dream.
Yes. if he's referring to Bush's dream, the American Dream Act, where everyone can get a house if he can breathe, that dream? What dream?
Well, you know, I guess it has to be rebuilt because if it actually happened, it wouldn't have been a dream. So you can't, it's not like rebuilding, like restoring America. They're talking about rebuilding a dream that people once had of what this could be and it didn't happen. So they want to dream it again. Is that what he's referring to?
I have no idea. But he wants the generational divide. That's his platform. He's pushing his youth and vitality as an asset. So this makes me believe that Martin O'Malley is a hipster and he wants to, you know, preach to this generation that he's building their dream, man. I don't know. That's what I get from it.
Okay.
I don't know. I haven't even heard anything about him ever.
Neither have I.
So I guess it doesn't
sounds like
matter.
About
but
a,
that's
like
what it literally, that's what it literally, that's what he literally has said that he's running on. Okay, so the next person is Bernie Sanders.
All right, Bernie Sanders. I will say this.
United States Senator.
Yeah, of Vermont. He does seem kind of cool on, you know, police accountability and, you know, the whole anti-drug war and anti-war period. I give him props on that stuff. But when it comes to quote unquote free education and mandatory voting registration,
what is
and
this free
huge
stuff?
High taxation everywhere left and right and government control over everything.
What is this free stuff? Like, I love when people are like, oh, free. It's like, they might as well be saying, oh, and there'll be rainbows, and at the end of the rainbows will be leprechauns and gold, and it'll just go to everyone. But that's not what's going to happen.
No.
That's not what free means.
It's just going to be a lot of
somebody's
theft
paying,
and coercion.
And it's going to be you. More when we come back. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. So we left off on Bernie Sanders and his political slogan or whatever. I don't know.
Feel the burn? Isn't that
That would have been great. It says, I think people should be a little bit careful underestimating me. Period. I don't know. It kind of sounds like a threat, which I like.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it looks like it kind of has an, I don't know, like, or... Or like, as if, or I don't know.
He's the feel-good candidate. He's the feel-good candidate. He's kind of like the progressive Ron Paul.
Can I get a little bit more detail? Like, when you're saying on this political stuff,
I know, because like, yeah.
Ron Paul?
Like, yeah.
What does that mean?
Okay, all right. So, Ron Paul.
I don't even politics.
You know, Ron Paul is kind of like that guy on the right that, you know, like, he might be, you know, the hardcore, but like the hardcore libertarians. We're all for him. Like, it seems like all the hardcore progressives, like all the people that like can't stand Obama and Clinton, and you know they want someone that's really going to go in there and put in a lot.
Or
of
they
different
just
programs.
Want someone who isn't those people. Like they just want someone who isn't Obama or Hillary Clinton. Like no, that's what I think of when you say progressive. I don't know.
No, I think of progressives as you know people who want a lot more government and are very open about it. Like those people, like they're very, very open about like what they want.
Okay. Because I felt like even at International Students for Liberty Conference, like a lot of those people who were in the line with us trying to take a picture with Ron Paul were like, yes.
They're minarchists.
I like violence. Yes. Like, what do you mean? Like, I don't understand. Government's awesome. Like, and I felt like they were kind of progressive, and they're like standing in line to take a picture with an anarchist.
That's because you're so far down the rabbit hole, like anarchy wise. If you look at the left right paradigm in regards to voting and politics, like technically anarchists, in my opinion, are way farther right in regards to government conservative, not social conservatives.
And
obviously.
Some people just trip over that line.
Yeah, like, but like you're so past that.
There.
You know, most people that are conservatives when they have political conversations. it's with liberals. It's not with anarchists. So they're, from their perspective, they are like the anarchists. But like then we come into the pitch like, no, you're basically just like the liberals.
Yeah. I mean, I do get that sense. Even when I was doing, what was it, Young Americans for Liberty? Or, yeah, I think it was Young Americans for Liberty. And this girl, she was talking about abortion or something of that nature. And she was saying, oh, like, I do support, like, you know, pro-life and people who want to, like, rally for pro-life and voting for those people. And I was like, why are you voting for someone to make decisions about, like, your uterus if you're, like, for pro-choice or pro-life or whatever you're saying? Like, don't you think it should be the woman's decision? And then she was like, well, people wait until they're like so many months pregnant. And I was like, I mean, that's what, you know, they're saying, but do we really know like the implications of what happens if you wait that long to like have an abortion? Is not something pretty. It's something painful and horrible if you really did the research on it and how many people are actually waiting till like that term to do abortions. That's not something that they get to make decisions on based off a few cases. Like, people will face those kind of implications. And I was kind of, I didn't really understand how she was seeing voting for Hillary as fixing, like, an abortion, like, the abortion laws. Because I didn't understand why there are laws. Like, I just don't get it.
Well, okay, in regards to abortion laws and abortion funding, like, I'm all with conservatives in regards to, like, you know, taking away funding to Planned Parenthood, but anything else like that. But at the same time, I'm all in favor of cutting funding to every single government thing that is in existence because I don't want the government funded.
I mean,
and then funding something else.
I don't think it's the government's responsibility to pay for my abortions. I don't think it's the government's responsibility to pay for anyone's abortions.
Yeah.
I think that's a private matter. And as it has been proven, it can be privately funded for people who can't necessarily afford it, I guess. But I shouldn't have to pay for you to go get an abortion. But I also, you know, I also don't believe there should be any kind of laws in place about what someone can do to their own body. I feel like it's that person's decision 1,000,000%.
What is your position on selling babies? Like, no, hear me out. What if women who are pregnant, what if someone offered you like $20,000 not to abort it, but they get to keep the baby for like their own, like to have, like to adopt it, like to you have to pay adoption agencies thousands upon thousands of dollars. So what is are you okay with human beings selling other human beings babies that aren't even born yet? Black market adoption agencies.
This adoptions are ridiculous. I grew up in a foster system and it just doesn't make sense, like, that they put people, like, it's like when we were trying to adopt our puppy, which our little puppies, he's here. His name's Riker. He's cool. The Rebel Love pup. Anyway, his adoption was just like, we had to fill out paperwork. They asked all these questions and they just didn't hand you a dog, you know? But that was, and it's a private agency. Like, if someone wants to buy a baby and they really want a baby for genuine reasons that aren't, like, evil and horrible reasons, I guess. But at the same time, even if you go through the adoption process, you could still be giving your child to a horrible person.
Even if they were horrible conditions, you were going to have an abortion anyways and kill it.
Yeah.
So what's the difference if you just make $20,000 and give it to someone else to do the same thing? From your perspective, it's still a win on your side.
Wait, you're going to give the baby to someone that's going to kill it?
Why does it matter? You're trying, you're going to kill it anyways. So you're not the one doing it. Someone else is, and you got $20,000.
Okay, what's your question? I don't understand.
All I'm saying is, I don't know, that went way off the deep end. All I'm saying is, are you okay with there being a black market for selling newborn babies?
Okay, I'm sorry.
To prevent abortions.
You're making it really, like, like in one, painting it in one picture. I mean, I feel like people do black. I don't know. I feel like when you're handling a life, you want to be as responsible as possible, and you would hope people have decency. I think this is what it's all based off of. You know, we think people should be able to make their own decisions as long as it's not hurting anyone else. And I kind of think at that point, if you're having a child to put it in danger, is to do that, to give it just to anyone to put it in danger, no, I don't think that's right, because at that point you are harming someone.
Okay.
But no, I don't think in utero that person is someone.
Okay, say that person wasn't, you know, a violent person and someone that Jillian wanted. Would you be okay with selling?
No, I'm okay with black market babies. Yeah. I've already said yes. Yeah, okay with it. It's just, if it's for a for harm, I don't know. It's crossing that thin line, but you would hope people, I don't know, you'd hope people do the right thing, but who knows? More than when we come back.
Black market baby selling. Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we were talking about how there's all these different people apparently wanting to rule over all 300 some million of us here in North America, what's known to be the United States of America, which is nothing more than lines drawn on a map by people long since dead. But there's people running, and we're going to the named agents and then people that have name recognition that can somehow make a difference in Washington.
So first of all, behind us is a Vermont Supreme 2016 video. Because if you're going to vote for anyone, it should be Vermont Supreme and his boot. Okay, so the next person on my list is Jeb Bush. And I know this is everyone's favorite political candidate.
You know, if there was a candidate to win on the Republican side, I kind of hope it is Jeb Bush.
I will take nothing and no one for granted. I will run with heart. I will run to win.
Babe, did you know
is
that,
he, what did is you he, know Jeb, is that his acceptance speech?
Hey, you know what? Jeb Bush's wife is Mexican.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
Really?
Yes.
He married
he speaks Spanish fluently.
Oh, my God. So I'm guessing he doesn't support the Mexicante Berlin Wall.
He actually might. I don't know.
And
most likely he probably
gonna
does.
Going to deport his wife. His wife is Mexican or Hispanic?
Both.
Really?
If that's even possible. Yes.
That was super racist.
No.
Okay. So he says he's a money leader. Between his super PAC, Right to Rise, and the money raised by his campaign, Mr. Bush's war chest is larger than any of his rivals. What?
His war chest,
This just said he's a murderer. He's the biggest murderer. Like, this is why he should win.
Well, yeah. I mean, he's being legit about it, you know? He knows the game. He knows what he's doing.
He just is like
he's got the name recognition
like putting up a sign
with a Hispanic Mexican as his wife.
Wow.
Yeah, he's gonna tear through town.
He's a thug, apparently.
Yeah.
He has the largest war chest.
He's a Bush. What do you want? What do you expect?
I don't know. It's like, when I think of Bush, it's like, I think of cops. Like, when has anything good ever come from a Bush? And why would anyone ever want another one?
I don't know, but apparently two is enough. People want three of them.
People should be sick. And, you know, he could actually win.
Yeah.
I think he might actually win.
Because he's probably going to run against Hillary. It's going to be Bush versus Clinton.
Oh, my God. You think so?
I'm kind of hoping so.
That's disgusting.
I want to see people's reaction to it.
I can hope. Okay, can I be honest?
Yeah.
I'm rooting for Donald Trump.
You want him to win?
I think.
Are you down for the Trump?
I think he should win. I think he should win. I think he's the president America deserves. He's going to put up his Mexican Berlin Wall and start a world war. And, you know, we'll see where it goes from there. It's going to be an exciting ride. I think Donald Trump will cause the apocalypse that we've all been expecting.
He could create the downfall of the entire United States federal government. So in that aspect, like, I would support that.
It's not like it's up very strong. Like, anyway, like, we all know. Like, just take a look at our current situation. We're not in a good political... Like, it's nothing good is going on right now. And you're going to elect fucking Donald Trump to keep holding and balancing it on his pinky. That's going to... He's that. Oh, it'll be great to watch. I would personally.
He would be an entertaining president. Oh,
until he gets shot. You know, oh my God! Another assassination.
You know what would really cool is like once he's president. Whenever there's some sort of scandal, and I know that someone else in his administration got caught, like on camera, he would say, "You're fired." Like, he would do that.
Oh, my God. Will he start a White House reality TV show?
I hope so. That'd be fun to watch.
And then, yeah, he's...
It would be cool if he made a reality TV show.
He's the president America deserves. And I think he'll show America what it really is.
Think about the promos you'd see on TV, the commercials you'd see for this reality TV show.
He'd make the most American-lover Americas, like, sick of themselves. I think everyone would take a hard look at themselves and this country and the economy and Donald Trump's hairline, and they'd say, what has happened to the world? And I think that is the hard look that America needs to take at themselves to realize this system ain't working. We need to try something else.
I think Trump might be that.
I think Trump might be that. And that's why, people, I cast my vote for Donald Trump. Right next to Vermin Supreme. I mean, if Vermin Supreme won, all our problems would be solved.
Oh, yeah. I would love to see Vermin Supreme win.
So we had to vote for Vermin Supreme first. We have been very raunchy on this show.
Well, he's leading in his own polls. So the polls where you can only vote for Vermin Supreme, he is winning. He's probably going to win it.
So do you think Bush has more name recognition than Clinton? I think Bush has bad name recognition and Clinton
but isn't
has good.
Any publicity good publicity?
No, not in politics.
Well, it depends. I mean, some people like Bush for being Bush. There's huge Bush supporters.
You think
supporters
so?
Yeah, there's
you think some people
Bush,
are just like, that was a smart guy?
No,
like, you really, like, I just... Really?
You know what really drives me crazy, even though I'm not a conservative or anything like that anymore, is I don't understand how there's so many people on the left that still love Obama when those same people hated Bush for, like, all the drone attacks and wars. And then, like, everything that, like, Bush did pales in comparison to what Obama's done.
Well, Obama has the added factor of being black. So it's like...
He's got the swagger.
Yeah. It's like... Every time he does something that Bush does, he's like, but I'm black. And then people are like, oh, yeah, he's black.
Yeah, no, he's got this. Like, he's, cool, he's definitely the coolest president that's ever been in office.
Yeah, so it's like, oh, yeah, I just murdered a bunch of people, but I'm black, though. High five.
Yeah, and he smokes cigarettes.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think he's doing it intentionally, you know, being black, but... I just think that's why people are so facaded by it. Like, people are asking why it's so different. And that really is why. You know, I don't think race matters or color matters. And it probably doesn't matter to him. You know, he's probably up there like, yes, I'm getting away with this because I'm black.
Yeah, I don't think
you
he's
know?
Doing that.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. But I feel like that's why he's been able to get away with so much more. It's like the race card in reverse. And it's not even if he's meaning to play it. You know, Americans are brought up to think that way, you know? He's not. He's black, so how could he want to hurt, you know?
He hasn't done anything great for pretty much anyone.
No.
Like, he's broken every single one of his promises.
Yeah.
Like, I don't understand why a single person still follows.
Yeah, and I don't think anyone really is. I just think it's more of the... Well, you know,
he's our guy. We got it's basically you can't not support him because if you stop, then you're admitting you're wrong.
Yeah.
You know, and people still can't let go of that. I can see like in 2008, but if they voted again in 2012, that's scary shit.
Well, who else were they going to vote for? So stuff.
I know. It's
more,
very true.
It's more of that. It's always been, well, the lesser of two evils is still evil, so I'm going to vote for Obama. The lesser of two evils is still evil, so I'm going to vote for, hopefully, Donald Trump, because I would love
You know what another thing with Donald Trump, on a serious note, is sometimes I see some porcupines and whatnot in their posts supporting Trump. And I just,
really?
Yeah.
What did I say?
They're like, you know, America needs strong business leadership and blah, blah, blah.
He's filed for bankruptcy every single year since The Apprentice, like 2009, 2012. Like,
yeah, he knows when to hold them and he knows when to fold them.
He knows when to fold them. Like, he's been through corporate bankruptcy. And people are like, yeah, he's still around.
And he's still around. He's got money to spare.
That means jack fucking shit that he's still around.
Well, I still don't support him.
America deserves you, Trump. Hope you win. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were talking about the apocalypse and how it'll be brought upon soon. And on the break, Rob asked me if, you know, Clinton and Bush made it to the primaries.
That's my hope.
Then who I want to win. And I say, you know what? I go for Jeb because I just really don't want Hillary's
it is. It's Hillary's turn. It's She's done so turn. Much to no. get just to have it for her
no,
turn.
No, Hillary. No. Shame on you, Hillary. I mean,
how many people has she probably gotten killed just to get to that spot just to be on the ballot?
Well, someone should have told her that she just will never live.
Tell me, she would have been She'll president already if down. She got in the divorce. She ran as a rotom.
Well, she hyphenated, but it wasn't enough, Hillary, and I don't want you to win, and Jeb, go ahead and plummet and tank the economy. Spend it all up. Drink it all up, Jeb.
I kind of want to see Trump win because I think he can really destroy shit fast. But that being said,
yeah, he'll get it done faster.
He'll get it done
Jeb
fast.
Will try for a little bit, but
the beauty is a Bush Clinton election would just like destroy all like
morality. Everyone
morality
will go crazy
in the system. Like this is cannot actually be a real thing that these two families are still trying to vie for control of
I know.
This country.
Isn't it just a monarchy at that point?
Yeah,
like, it's like Game just of Thrones. It's running through the bloodline, and this point someone's gonna get shanked. I don't know. So there's another black guy running, Ben Carson. I'm probably never going to be politically correct because I'm not a politician.
He really doesn't like Muslims.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, he's like, I would never have a Muslim as president. I was like, I want to say, I don't want you want a president, let alone a Muslim or a Christian. Like, I don't want a president.
Like, who says shit like that?
I don't know.
Like, these are the people you're going to vote for. Like,
he's playing to
publicly just
look,
racist.
He's a black Republican playing to his base of racists. He's got to show some solidarity. Hey. That's what he's trying to do.
Hey, yeah. He's not racist. He just thinks he's superior to that race. Oh, nope, that's racism.
Yeah.
Okay, so Rand Paul. It doesn't have the same ring to it. I know you. I mean, if you're going to.
I hate Rand Paul.
Why do you hate him now? It wasn't you. You never say you hate him until now. I need to know why.
Well, I don't hate the guy. He's probably a nice guy. But I feel as if he's using the Paul name in a bad way. He's a politician. He's not even Ron Paul. I mean, yeah, politician, but for the most part, like he didn't like say things to better his chances of being elected.
Do you think he's just like trying to get attention from his daddy?
No.
Because Ron Paul, he should be an anarchist.
There are libertarians out there that really do believe that Rand Paul is just saying what he needs to do to get elected. And as soon as he gets in there, he's going to be Ron Paul in office.
You know what I think? I think that he
But I don't believe that.
I think he's angry at his father for being such a hippie that he wanted to challenge him by being a conservative. And now he's like, daddy, show me attention. And he's being like a little shit and like
he's trying to make a name for himself. But I mean, same time, he still tries to play off the libertarian thing. You see all these people going with staying with Rand, and he's been good on a couple things, but like he is not his dad in any way, shape, or form. He's done a lot of things I don't agree with.
Okay, it's time for a new way. A way predicted on justice, opportunity, and freedom. Sounds like murderous. I'm sorry.
He's for sanctions on other countries, especially Iran. He's very anti-Iran. He's not against there being military being used. Hell, he's talked about how he thinks it's okay for a drone to be used to kill someone over a matter of $50 and a gun walking out of like a convenience store. I mean, he's okay with
Jails, just murder.
Yeah, apparently, and that's if there's $50 involved, sure. You know, he's also in favor of the drug war. Like he's not even on the point where he thinks that like you should be able to have, you know, and sell a plant. Like he's not even on that level.
Okay, but this is why I don't get it, because his dad is nothing like that. Like, why would he? How could he have raised such a little bastard? I don't understand that. Like.
Well, I mean, here's the thing. There's people, there are libertarians, and there's anarchists and whatnot that believe that, you know, Rand Paul is just saying what he needs to say to get elected and to get, he's going in as a full politician mode. But when he gets in, it's going to be Ron Paul. It's going to be Ron Paul all the way. You know, and he's going to point he's going to point Andrew Napolitano to like either on the Supreme Court, or he's going to be, on a judiciary branch or an attorney general, you know, like people are going to love that.
Okay,
shit.
So
Liberty dream going on.
No, but you just talked me into why I don't want that to happen, because I don't want to replace another system with a system. My goal is for no system. So if he's planning to get in there and change the system, you can't change the system. I don't want to change. I don't want a system. So it's that doesn't appeal to me. I'm definitely for Donald Trump.
Well, yeah. See, that's the thing. Sometimes you look at politics and you kind of look at like, who's gonna destroy the system faster so we can rebuild? You know, let's not drag out the end. Let's just get to the end and start over.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of people that look at it that way, where they want the end to happen fast so that it's recoverable, not be dragged out for generations.
I am definitely one of those people, because I mean, I tried to look at things in a minarchist perspective, and you know, I can't do it. It's like I came too deep down this rabbit hole, and I just think that this system, it can't be fixed. It's broken beyond repair, and we need to just start over. And who knows what the answer to that is, but this is definitely not the answer, and people are like dying in the process of this. So the faster it happens, maybe we save a life or a bunch of lives droned away. but I mean, I definitely won't be voting. I think the only time I will vote is 2020 for Yeezus, if we haven't, you know, destroyed ourselves.
What about Kanye? You're gonna vote for Kanye?
Kanye is Yeezus.
Oh, that's right. Yeezus. I don't pay attention to this.
You need to, yeah. In 2020, Kanye West will run.
That's right. He's
and
Yeezus.
Then I'll vote for him, because Kanye West should definitely be the president.
What about these nuts?
Oh, D's Nuts 2016.
Yeah.
He's running. I don't know from what platform.
I don't believe he's even old enough to run.
Yeah, he was like 15, I think. He probably wasn't running, but he has like a 9% vote in the polls. Rick Santorum is running. Why does that name sound familiar?
Because he ran before. He's horrible. He's a horrible conservative. Like, he's like the hardcore conservative.
What is his slogan? Working families don't need another president tied to big government or big money.
I believe there's a famous Free Stater video where Ian Freeman.
Oh, asked him if he Googled himself. That's where I know him from. Yeah. I was like, it's not his politics. It can't be. Because doesn't it mean something like anal asshole probing or something?
Something like that. I forget.
Like toilet fishing.
It was a big thing at the time.
Sex act. Oh, yeah. That would be great. And then everyone would be Googling Santorum and just getting that. Hopefully it gets popular.
I don't think he has any chance of winning this year. Just this time around again. Well, I can't believe he's still running again.
Well,
like,
we all
no one, that didn't think anyone cared last time around. Not that I care for any of these people to begin with.
Well, you know who else I thought should have won? Well, now I think he should have ran again and maybe won. Mitt Romney.
What?
He was so stupid. It was just like, it was like watching like a 5-year-old.
He's one of those people too that thinks it's his time too.
Yeah,
you know, like, he'll keep running. I can't believe he's not running. Yeah, that's
literally him. Here's his quote. He's so smug. He's like, I didn't want to make it more difficult for someone else to emerge who may have a better chance at becoming the president.
Now, here's the thing. All right, Ron Paul did the same thing. He just kept running. He kept running and running and running. You know, he ran 2008. He ran again in 2012. He ran before that too. He ran back in what, 88? For president 3 times.
He should have won. But he said he's not running because he wants to give other people a chance, basically. So it's, you know, like, for class president, like, no, I'm not gonna run. I want to give Stephanie a chance. Like, what the fuck does he think this is, high school? Like, I'm gonna pass on being the president this time.
Yeah, like, no. Well, in all honesty, he's getting too old to be president. Like, Ron Paul doesn't have that many years left to him.
Oh, not Ron Paul, Mitt Romney.
Oh, Mitt Romney.
But no, I mean, I felt like if anyone was gonna win, it should have been him because zombie apocalypse. But anyway, thanks for watching.
And you can find, well, first, baby doll, where can everyone find you?
You can find me at The Rebel Mistress on Facebook.
All right, and you can find all of our content for Rebel Love Show at rebellove.com. Peace, guys.